Suryapet Chilalo, Governor Jishnu Devarma Paratistanarika, Paratilo Baganga Kuda, a month later Palguna, Marina Patilo, Matri Utankumar, demarted the Nepal Chita.
Kane and a crura manastatum Jaganmo hundred D, crura manastatum.
Minister said in his video conference on collectors, it has to be done flawlessly. You have any problems, please get back to the Civil Service Commissioner immediately. Okay, any issues. And please keep ready sufficient amount of intermediate godowns. You can have both arrangements of working with the rice millers and of having intermediate godowns. Now, sir, irrigation, this district is blessed to have the Krishna River flowing on one side, right through one side. And from end to end, and the Nagarjun Sagar Dam is in the combined Nalgonda district, but the main left canal flows through entirely the Suryapet district. Like the collector explained to you, the Nagarjun Sagar project, SRSP, Musi project, lift irrigation schemes, and the tanks, totally the aycut is about 6.16 lakh acres. We are continuously trying to increase that so that irrigation water should reach every acre. That's the way we are going forward. I must briefly take you back to the history of Suryapet district and to the history of Telangana. Telangana had a very checkered history. We did not become independent on 15th August 1947. As you must be aware, sir, in the erstwhile Nizam state, when India became independent, Nizam was yet acceding to the state. So then anyway, there was one is this area, even before independence, has been a hotbed of revolutionary movements, including the communist movement against the then Jagirdari landlord movement. Thousands of people were killed, and land reforms in its initial stages was there. That was the just before independence, when the there was an armed struggle against excess land holding, and then of course the armed struggle continued against the Razakars of the Nizam time. Then anyway, after 1947, various kinds of parleys took place between the then Jawaharlal Nehru government and the Nizam, and you'll be happy to know that in September 1948, through this on this road which you came, tanks moved from Vijayawada to Hyderabad. That is then when the then Nizam accepted to surrender to the Union of India. So this was the road on which the border of the Telangana and Andhra Pradesh is very close by here. So Suryapet, you cross this district, you enter Andhra Pradesh. So it's on this road that in 1948, the tanks of the Indian Army moved towards the Hyderabad city, and that's when the Nizam agreed to accede to the Indian Union. And to tell you very briefly about the other activities in the district, sir. This district is the largest cement manufacturing hub of India. It's because limestone, which is the main raw material for cement industry, is located abundantly here. So in one cluster, this is in Huzurnar constituency, that's where I represent an MLA, sir. The largest number of cement industries in India are in that hub because the limestone is there. And then we have some very good pharmaceutical industries. And because paddy is grown extensively, there is also a fairly vast rice milling industry in this area. And I'm also happy to inform you that this is a highly aware district. Communism has seen very strong roots in this area. And everybody, the farmers, the normal public also are very highly aware. And it's been my extreme good fortune that I have represented this district 7 times, 6 times in the assembly and once in the parliament. And as I introduced you yesterday, my wife is the MLA from the other constituency. So, you know, most of the district, it's like all like family members to me. And we are very happy. And for all officers of Suryapet district, it's a great honor and a privilege for us that such a distinguished person has come as a governor today and come to our district. And on this occasion, I urge all of you that in whatever duties assigned to you, as a district minister, I urge you that we must work with all honesty, sincerity, and full commitment. And for each of you, my, as long as you approach honestly and sincerely and diligently. Collector, thank you very much. You can continue.
So with your permission, I'll introduce the other dignitaries to you, sir. So you're already introduced to Honorable Minister Sri Uttam Kumar Reddy, sir. Sir, Honorable MLA, Kodad Assembly Constituency, Srimati Nalamada Padmavati Reddy Garu, sir. You're also introduced, sir. Sir, apart from that, in the district today, we have representation from municipal chairperson, sir, and also we have
yes sir.
So Perimula Annapurna garu, sir, chairperson Suryapet municipality, sir. Then we have Gelli Archana garu, chairperson Huzurnagar municipality, sir. Then Srimati Sangati Anusuya garu, who's municipal chairperson Tirumalagiri municipality, sir. We also have presence of Sri Cheveti Venkanna garu, sir, who is member of Telangana Agriculture and Farmers Welfare Commission, sir. Sir, apart from that, we have some special invitees who are doing well in various walks of life, sir. With your permission, will sir, district officers, sir, I'll request the district officers one by one to introduce themselves, sir. I'll start with myself, sir. I'm Tejas Power, district collector, sir. I request SP Garu.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Sanpreet Singh, sir. I am SSP of the district, sir.
Youth and sports officer, Suryapet.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is V.V. Appara, DRDO and CEO of JP in charge.
Namaskaram, sir. My name is Dr. Kota Chalam, sir, District Medical and Health Officer, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Ravi Kumar, District Treasurer Officer, Suryapet, sir.
Good morning. Good afternoon, sir. I'm Dr. Srinivas Rao, District Veterinarian and Animal Husbandry Officer. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Sridhar Reddy, District Agriculture Officer, Suryapet, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Ashok, District Education Officer, Suryapet.
Namaskar, sir. My name is Rajeshwar, sir. District Civil Supply Officer, Suryapet, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Sir, namaskaram, sir. Nagaya, sir. District Horticulture and Sericulture Officer.
Namaste, sir. I am Ramesh Babu, Chief Engineer, Irrigation Department, sir.
Sir, namaskaram, sir. I am Sitaramaya, District Officer, R&B Department, Suryapet.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Franklin, Superintendent Engineer, TGSPDCL, sir. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Tejav Sitaram, sir, District Industry Department.
Sir, namaskaram, sir. I am Venkatesh Parlu, Superintendent Engineer, Rural Water Supply Department.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Arunakar Reddy, Executive Engineer, Rural Water Supply.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. My name is J. Ramesh Kumar, DPRO, Suryapet, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Srinivas Rao, sir. My mission is the Intra, Executive Engineer, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. I am C.V. Lakshmar Reddy, Irrigation Officer, Suryapet, sir.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, వెంకటయ్య ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్ ఇంజనీర్ పంచాయతీరాజ్ డిపార్ట్మెంట్ కోదాడ్ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, రామ్కిషోర్ ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్ ఇంజనీర్ ఇరిగేషన్ హుజూర్ నగర్ డివిజన్ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, సత్యనారాయణ ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్ ఇంజనీర్ ఇరిగేషన్ కోదాడ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ బాలు సార్, డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ గ్రౌండ్ వాటర్ ఆఫీసర్ సార్ సూర్యాపేట.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మై నేమ్ భానత్ నాగులు సార్, ఐఎమ్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ ఫిషరీస్ ఆఫీసర్ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ టిఎన్ఎస్ ప్రసాద్, ఐఎమ్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ మేనేజర్ సివిల్ సప్లైస్ కార్పొరేషన్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ బి శ్యామ్ సుందర్ ప్రసాద్, డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ ఆడిట్ ఆఫీసర్ సార్.
సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, ఐఎమ్ జయపాల్ రెడ్డి, ఎగ్జిక్యూటివ్ ఇంజనీర్ మెడికల్ ఇన్ఫ్రా
సార్. సార్ గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, వి బానోనే ఇంటర్మీడియట్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మై నేమ్ ఇస్ సతీష్, ఐఎమ్ జిఏడి డిపార్ట్మెంట్ పర్సనల్ అసిస్టెంట్ టు ఆనరబుల్ మినిస్టర్.
నమస్తే సార్, నా పేరు బాపూజీ, లీడ్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ మేనేజర్ సార్.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మైసెల్ఫ్ కే జగదీశ్వర రెడ్డి, డిస్ట్రిక్ట్ మైనారిటీస్ వెల్ఫేర్ ఆఫీసర్ సార్. థ్యాంక్ యూ.
గుడ్ ఆఫ్టర్నూన్ సార్, మల్లేశం డిఈ ఐ అండ్ పిఆర్ సార్, ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ అండ్ పబ్లిక్
రిలేషన్. Sir, and now I request Honorable Governor sir to give his initial remarks and his best wishes for the district sir. Your comments will be taken up seriously by the district administration. Honorable Minister sir is also here, so you can give your message and blessings to the district.
Good afternoon. It sounds.
Good afternoon to all, and seated with me is the Honorable Minister and Srimati Reddy, who I met just yesterday, I think, and had a long talk with them regarding your district. It's a very rare occasion when you meet a politician of his stature. He was an MLA 7 times, and prior to that, he served the nation as a fighter pilot. Then he served as a people's representative. Today, he's serving the nation as a minister of the state. And Mrs. Reddy also is the people's representative. Seated with me is the Principal Secretary, the Government of Telangana, the District Magistrate Collector, the SP, the Joint Secretary, and other officials who are there. And it's a very nice interaction because I felt that, you know, the eminent persons are also present. They also get an insight into their own district. As the administration works for the upliftment of the district or the development of the district, so does the, you know, eminent people, the poets, the writers, the artists. They also silently work to make the life better in the district or in the state or in the nation. We're all contributors in our own ways. They are also contributing. So they are also today here. That's a very nice thing to do. And I must congratulate the district for inviting them here and making them a part of the interaction. And I hope you'll do it quite often. Because they should be inclusive. I always believe that all development work should be inclusive, and the action for development is actually a movement. As the Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister says, Sabka Prayas. He stresses on the word, the Prime Minister always says, Sabka Prayas, with the effort of all. And I'm happy to know that this district has become ODF, because it is a barometer for, analyzing how people have been involved here in the Swachh Bharat mission. The Swachh Bharat is not a government program. It is a movement to make our nation clean. And it has, when it started first, we were thinking, what is this Swachh Bharat? What is this toilet business we are talking about? Then as it grew, then we realized that how a government program can become a movement, an inclusive movement for all. And I was listening to the health part, and I just noticed that the anemia has been brought down from 73% to 21%. That is a milestone. And I would like the district collector to share the details. Because we in Rajbhavan, we have adopted 6 villages where there's a lot of anemia in the tribal population. So you share the details with us, we'll be happy to know the action plan, how it has been done in this district. From 73% to 21% is almost 50% reduction, which is a very big milestone. Send it to us, how this Suryapet has done this wonderful job. So we'll, you know, replicate it maybe. Some points we can replicate in our, you know, villages that we have adopted. And the SSG movement is very, I always take a lot of interest in SSG. Because I know that 50% of the society is women. Today we are talking of women empowerment. We have realized very lately that we cannot leave out half the country and, you know, enjoy development, fruits of development. So when I was coming to this office, I saw these stalls. And they are very interesting, the embroidery stall, which is very new. The, you know, the food stall, the masalas they were making were also very, very nice. And I saw your success stories here of the SSGs. And these success stories need to be, you know, propagated even more. And we should put up posters of these women who are successful SSGs. So they should be, you know, the role models. And SSGs are important because money going into the hands of women stays in the family. It is used for the family. So empowering our lady is empowering the family, is empowering the society. For a better life, that is most necessary. Especially in rural areas, I believe and completely believe that the empowerment of women will make our development sustainable. As the Honorable Minister is saying, that Telangana is developing very rapidly. And in that rapid development, we must ensure that the last man is not left behind. We must include them. Our effort should always be to include the marginalized people. Because leaving a section behind does not work well. It, you know, generates dissent and disgruntlement. So, as we go along, we have to move rapidly and fast. If you have to become Vikasit Bharat, we have to do it in 2047, as the Prime Minister says. But in our move towards 2047, Vikasit Bharat, let's make every part of society Vikasit. And in that, the district administration plays a pivotal role. And the marginalized people are the strength of this country. We have to take them along. Otherwise, that development will become very painful development. So let's make development sustainable and without pain. So there's a smile in every face, hope in every eye. That is the development that we envisage for India. And the hospital, your district hospital also is very, very good as per the presentation. I was quite impressed that about 3,000 general surgery cases have taken place. For us in Northeast, that's a very big thing. Because our district hospitals don't do that kind of volume of work. And healthcare is a very, very difficult in Northeast because of the terrain and everything like that. And education also, I saw that you have increased to up to 96% of your students have cleared the exams. That is also a very nice thing for us to hear. And I was in the stalls here. I like the teaching tools. They were very simple and very nice, but very interesting. I hope they are used in the classrooms, yes, and not only in stalls. They should be used. They should be used in the classrooms. They're very interesting. They're very interesting for children. These are very new things, as we as children never saw them. Yes. We were asked to mug up things and finish. Do your homework and come to school. But these are very interesting things that children will remember. Education is also remembering, no? We were in our time, we were just, you know, reading books, coming with a pen, writing down what we can remember and going home. After that, you forget about it. But now these small, small tools make the, you know, education interesting. And in an internet age, these are required. These are very much required now, especially, when you can just press the phone and know things. People don't understand things. People know things nowadays. The age of information, people are well informed, less educated. So let's be informed and let's be educated. That is important. And agriculture, though you are blessed with an irrigation minister, and your agriculture is doing very well, as he has said. He has also given me a little history of Telangana, which I knew a little bit because, you know, we had a communist leader there by the name of Yuvan Chakravarti, who was a Politburo member when we were very young. He used to tell us the stories of our Telangana movement. The small, small stories we heard about Telangana movement and the importance of Telangana. And Tripura also joined India after 47. We signed the instrument of merger in 1949. And there are many things that Tripura and Telangana share. I was telling the principal secretary also one day when we were talking that the first two cameras came to India. Yes. One was for my great-grandfather, one was for Lala Deen Dayal. We also joined India, the Union of India late in 49. So there are many things that we share. And though Telangana is moving very fast, it's in the fast lane of development. And we in Northeast are a little lagging behind, but with a little push, we will reach there, we hope. And it's very nice to meet you all, and the eminent persons have all come. I must thank them for coming and taking part in the presentation. You may not be in the district administration, but I always believe the people like you also serve the society silently and purposefully to make lives better. Whether you write a poem, or you are a doctor, or you are an engineer, or you are a social worker, everyone contributes to making, taking India into 2047. Viksit Bharat does not only mean economically, sound. We think that Viksit Bharat means we have to just count the rupees and our foreign exchange reserve. It is not that. Because the soul of a society is in its culture. The soul of a society is in its culture. Its civilizational definition is in its culture, not in how much bank balance we have. So that is also important. That defines India, its diversity. And this district is very nice. When I was looking at places of interest, I saw a temple, Hindu temple. I saw a Christian church. I saw Buddhist monuments. I saw a mosque. Yes. So this district is very, very, inclusive district. So we must keep it like that. When we talk of diversity, we don't mean that, there must be unity also. Or when we talk of unity, we don't speak of uniformity. We don't say everything should be the same. It is not possible, it is unnatural, impractical, it is a fallacy. But when we talk of, when we talk of diverse ways, we talk of unity, not a uniformity. There's no uniformity in any place. India itself is not uniform. No two human beings are alike. Different types of flowers, different types of, birds. And there will be different types of cultures, different types of beliefs. You take them along. And that is development, including everyone. That's why the Prime Minister keeps saying, Sabka Vikas, Sabka Saath, Sabka Prayas, Sabka Biswas. The word sab is always there. He's talking of unity, of uniting people, not of, uniformity, that everything should be same. Sab parade karte chalo, aisa nahi hai. All go together, and we are happy that today the officials are here. You creative people and people who are serving the society also here. You went through a presentation of your district. And I'm sure it will make you proud that the minister is also here. Srimati Reddy is also here. We are all here to work together and make Telangana prosperous to build a Viksit Bharat. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your wonderful support and guidance to the districts. Now we will request the eminent citizens of this state. Among them, the most prominent is Dushyala Satyanarayana. Dushyala Satyanarayana, can you stand up? Ralayana? Yes, he did. Huh? So he has not come, sir, but Satyanarayana excels that he created 70 acres of his own land into a natural forest where nothing is harvested, nothing is allowed to be used by people. Everything is left to nature. Suppose a tree is fallen,
a natural forest.
Means it's not for human beings. He says it is for the nature. Means the birds should come and eat. No human being is allowed to touch anything there. So, new concept. If a tree is fallen, it is allowed to decay and become the manure by itself. Nobody will be allowed to touch, cut. Or even good fruits come, not allowed to be touched by human beings. Let birds come and eat. So he has done that exclusively, sir. There are 31 of them one by one collector can go through and they can introduce themselves.
Yes. Sir, I'd like to introduce Perni Rajkumar Garu, who's also a popular for his outstanding performances and keeping up the heritage of the Perni dancer.
Namaskar ji. मेरे को जानते पेरनी नाट्यम से नरेंद्र मोदी जी भी हमारा डांस देखकर बहुत बढ़िया वो बोलते एंड हमको जान हमारा तेलंगाना में ये कल्चर को हम बचाने के लिए आगे लेके जाने के लिए हमारा संस्कृति हमारा सांप्रदाय को 101 दिन नॉन स्टॉप परफॉर्मेंस किया स्कूल्स में टेंपल्स में उस जानकारी से हमको आज यहाँ मौका मिला है आपसे मिलने के लिए थैंक यू धन्यवाद
सर वी इनिशियली द डांस परफॉर्मेंस व्हिच वाज देयर सर द डांस वाज द पेरनी डांस व्हिच वी सॉ यस सर नेक्स्ट इज श्री सुधाकर रेड्डी गारु सर हू इज अ गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट एंड नेशनल अवार्ड विनर सर ही इज अ रिटायर्ड IRS ऑफिसर हू इज पॉपुलर फॉर वॉलीबॉल गेम सर एंड ही हैज परफॉर्मड इन वेरियस गेम्स सर आई
Sir, good afternoon, sir. I am Sudhakar Reddy, retired Assistant Commissioner of Customs and GST Department. I am recruited as a sportsman quota in volleyball, as an inspector in central government department. So, I played is the 4 times nationals and 2 times is the national champion, sir. So, I am retired 2006 onwards. I am doing is the social service of the sports encouragement. Thank you a lot.
Next to Ravinder Reddy Garu, who's a renowned kabaddi player, sir. National Kabaddi Player Championship is presently working in.
Good evening, sir. Na peru Devasam Ravinder Reddy, maa swasthalam Hujanagar, sir. Nenu mana Telangana nunchi oka aaru national anano. Adhe vidhanga naa kreedanu mechukoni naaku 2006 lo Andhra Bank lo ప్యూర్ స్పోర్ట్స్ కోటలో ఉద్యోగం ఇచ్చారు ప్రజెంట్గా నేను మా ఊర్లోనే హుజూర్నగర్లో హెడ్ క్యాషర్ వర్క్ చేస్తున్నాను సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్ నేను ఒక గేమ్తోటే ఈరోజు సెంట్రల్ గవర్నమెంట్ ఉద్యోగం బ్యాంకులో చేస్తున్నంటే ఒక క్రీడ సార్ కానీ ఇంతమంది పెద్దవాళ్ళు మాట్లాడారు ఇంత చెప్పారు కానీ స్పోర్ట్స్ గురించి ఒక్కరు కూడా చెప్పలేదు సార్ మాకు చాలా బాధగా ఉంది ఈ సూర్యాపేట జిల్లాలో స్పోర్ట్స్ అగ్రగామిగా ఉండాలని మీ వంతు సహాయ సహకారాలు అందించాలని ఈ సంభావముఖం తెలియజేస్తున్నాను సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్ అదేవిధంగా మా ఉత్తమ కుమారెడ్డి సార్ గారు మాకు ఏదైనా అడిగిన వెనువంటనే చేస్తారు వారు కూడా ముందు మా స్పోర్ట్స్ మీద కొంచెం దృష్టి పెట్టాలని తెలియజేస్తుంది సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్
నెక్స్ట్ మధుసూదన్ రావు గారు హూజ్ అ నేషనల్ బెస్ట్ టీచర్ అవార్డ్
నేషనల్ అవార్డీ ఫర్ టీచర్స్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్
నెక్స్ట్ బి వెంకటేశ్వర్లు గారు ఆల్సో నేషనల్ బెస్ట్ టీచర్ అవార్డీ సార్
మై నేమ్ ఈస్ బి వెంకటేశ్వర్లు మరి ఎడ్యుకేషన్లో ఎన్రోల్మెంట్ పెంచడం డ్రాప్అవుట్ని నిరోధించడం మరి ఇంకా ఇతరత్ర కార్యక్రమాలు చేయడం జరిగింది దానివల్ల నాకు నేషనల్ అవార్డు ఇచ్చేయడం జరిగింది థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్
థ్యాంక్ యూ నెక్స్ట్ కట్కూరి చంద్రారెడ్డి
కరెక్ట్ గారు 1 మినిట్ దట్స్ రవీందర్ రెడ్డి నో యు ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఫర్ స్పోర్ట్స్ ఫెసిలిటీస్ we will do whatever is required some proposals to me
ji sir
you have a meeting with them yes. What exactly they are looking at we'll try to get it sanctioned
noted sir okay.
Thank you sir
next Katkuri Chandra Reddy
namaskaram sir nenu telugu lambada bhasha rendu bilingual sambandhinatundi dantlo girijana bhasha ఈ యొక్క ట్రైబల్ లాంగ్వేజ్లు సంబంధించినటువంటి దాని మీద ముఖ్యంగా చేయటం జరిగింది ఆ తర్వాత రాష్ట్రంలో ఒక 5 ఇయర్స్ విద్య అనేటువంటిది ఎడ్యుకేషన్ సిస్టమ్ మొత్తం కూడా మా స్కూల్ బేస్గా నడవడం జరిగింది స్టేట్ ఇంటరాక్టివ్ మెటీరియల్ వర్క్షాప్ను కండక్ట్ చేయడం జరిగింది అదే ఒక 18 పుస్తకాలు ఆ యొక్క వర్క్షాప్లో తయారు కావడం జరిగింది ఆ యొక్క బేస్తోనే నాకు 2009లో నేషనల్ అవార్డు అనేది రావడం జరిగింది సార్ థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్
Right. Thank you. Next to Tumu Srinivasa Rao.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Thum Srinivas Rao. I am working as a school student at JPHS Pillamar in Suryapet district. I am participating in various science fairs and I got the prizes in South Indian Science Fair 3 times, 6 times state level prizes and 15 times district level prizes. And I am also worked as a MRP, I mean Mandal Resource Person, District Resource Person and State Resource Person in various educational programs like APEP, EPSHAP, DPEP, SSA, RVM, RMSA, like all educational implementation programs, I am working as a research person. And I am attending so many workshops in the state and I am giving the so much time and giving the so much achievements to the society, the school children. This is my about my work done, sir.
Great. Thank you. Next to Sri Meela Mahadev, the Rale. Okay. Next to Uchar. Okay. So he's a national award for best industrialist.
Good afternoon, all. I am Meela Mahadev, managing director, Sudhakar PVC Prosper Center. Our industry started in 1971. Now in Suryapet, now we are having 9 industries in Ujjain, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh also. So I'm the present, we are increasing the our production capacity and marketing also. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So next is P. Umarani, Panchayat Secretary. She is Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Panchayat Secretary Vikasit Puraskar Awardee for 2023, sir.
My name is Y. Umarani, Apur Gram Panchayat, awarded Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Panchayati Satat Vikas Puraskar in the theme of 9, Women Friendly Panchayat. Thank you, sir.
Next to Kutta Bandrayachari. He's a popular stage artist, sir, in the and also Nandi Award. Please.
నా పేరు కొత్త భద్రయాచారి. మాది హుజూర్నగర్ నియోజకవర్గం, మఠంపల్లి మండలం, అల్లీపురం గ్రామం, సార్. మేము ఎక్కువగా పౌరాణిక నాటక రంగంలో గత 35-40 సంవత్సరాల నుండి నాటకాలు ఆడుతూ ఉన్నాము. తిరుపతి, నెల్లూరు, ఒంగోలు, హైదరాబాదు ఇంకా మొదలైన చోట మరి ఎన్నో జాతీయ స్థాయిలో పురస్కారాలు తీసుకోవడం జరిగింది. అవకాశం ఇస్తే ఒక చిన్న డైలాగ్ చెప్తా సార్.
చెప్పు
తండ్రి, ఇదంతయు ఆ మాయావి తిమ్మరసు పన్నాగము కవన మన కాలు మోపిన కాలకాలు నేను కవన నీక నిలవరింపజాను 16 పాత్రములు కవన మన కాలు మోపకుండానే నిలవరించి నిర్వీర్యులను గావించిన ఆ తిమ్మరసు అఖండ మేధాశక్తి అమోఘమే అవుగాక అరిరాజ కంఠలంత నాసక్త మగు మదీయ కరవాలము ఆ దృఢ యాజ్ఞవుని కంఠరక్త బాణమున అరుణారుణ రాగ రంజితో దీప్తి వెలుగొందలేదని ఆ లేక క్షత్రియ కుల కలంకితుడు దాసీపుత్రుడగు ఆ కృష్ణరాయల రక్తనాళములను తెగగోయలేదని ఆ తండ్రి సంధి చేసి తిరి. థ్యాంక్ యూ సార్.
నెక్స్ట్ శ్రీ ఎస్కే ముస్తఫా గారు.
నాది పాలకేడు మండలం, జాన్పాడ్ సార్. మా నాన్నగారి కానించి రంగస్థల నాటకం కళ అనేది వంశ పరిపాలనగా వస్తున్నది. నా పేరు షేక్ ముస్తఫా. రాష్ట్ర రంగస్థల కళాకారుల ఐక్యవేదిక నుంచి శ్రీరాముడు పాత్రలో నంది అవార్డు తీసుకున్నానండి. 9 సార్లు నంది అవార్డులో, 4 సార్లు సెలెక్ట్ అయినండి 9 సార్లకి. మరి ఇది దీనినే వృత్తిగా భావించుకొని నడిపిస్తున్నామండి. మీరు అవకాశం ఇస్తే ఒక పద్యం పాడతా సార్. నేను ఆర్య అఖండ ప్రతిభాధుర్య పాలించిన వసుధాతలమునాడు పరరాజకోటి భీవచ్చ పడగా కావించిన వట గణ్య తపో దీక్ష ముల్లోకములుగూడ తల్లడిలగా సృష్టించిన వటం చెలగి నూతన సృష్టి బ్రహ్మ విద్యకు కొత్త పాఠమనగా
వినోబటం లోక లోకాలలో బ్రహ్మరథముతోడ పాద పూజం సాటిలేని మీ మేటి చరిత మేము నిత్యమాలిల్చుచుంటి మీ నాటి వరకు నేడు మేము చూచు భాగ్యంబు కూడి వచ్చే మునివారా మము దీవింప మృక్కువాడ
నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ డాక్టర్ ఆనంద్ దొంగే ఈఎన్టీ
స్పెషలిస్ట్ ఇన్ ద సూర్యాపేట్ టౌన్ అండ్ ఐ వాజ్ ట్రైన్డ్ ఎట్ ముంబై వెన్ మై ఫినిషింగ్ ఆఫ్ మై పోస్ట్ గ్రాడ్యుయేషన్ ఐ వాజ్ ట్రైన్డ్ ఎట్ ముంబై ఐ వాజ్ ట్రైన్డ్ ఫర్ ఐఎల్టీఎస్ అడ్వాన్స్డ్ లైఫ్ సపోర్టివ్ ట్రీట్మెంట్ అండ్ ఐ కేమ్ టు దీస్ ప్లేస్ ఐ డోంట్ నో మెజారిటీ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ ఆర్ డైయింగ్ డ్యూ టు ద బేసిక్ థింగ్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ALTS and I mean resuscitation and ABCD treatment, sir. A is airway, B is breathing, C is circulation. If we did these three, and probably with God's, his intention by my hand, I could able to rescue 3,500 odd patients in needy time, sir. And all the doctors of Suryapet, whatever may be the place in 24/7, I'll keep my phone with me. Whatever may be the emergency requirement is there, I'm going in rendering the services. I'm 48 years now, sir. If all the things will be in a hand, the last breath of mine, I will rush out and I'll try to rescue each and every human being, sir.
Thank you so much, Andy.
I did around 700 surgeries in association with Arogya Sri at area hospital. Before starting of this medical college, sir, probably that was all-time record of Telangana state, that cadre hospital, sir.
Right. Thank you so
much.
Thank
you very much, sir.
Thank you. Next, MD Medicine.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. I am working in Kodad since last 15 years. My subspecialty is diabetes. I am not only treating diabetes, I am doing a lot of free tests for diabetes. I am giving the importance of preventing the complications of diabetes, retinopathy, neuropathy, nephropathy. So treating is not at all, treating is important, but prevention also important. I am trying to avoid giving the awareness about the preventing the complications of diabetes. And I will treat the who came with complications like cerebrovascular accident, who came with myocardial infarction. So I'm giving a few hundreds of patients who came with complications like pneumonia. So since last 15 years, I'm doing this service, sir, in my native place, Kodad.
Thank you, Dr. Garu. Next is Shri T. Shashidhar Garu, advocate.
His Excellency, Honorable Sri Jishnadeva Rosab, it's a great opportunity and privilege to have you today with the people of Suryapeta district, sir. It amounts to diversity to democracy. And you are absolutely wonderful to have distinguished between the unity and uniformity, a wonderful clarity what we today have got from this dais, sir, called sincerity. Being a legal services authority member since last more than 16 years, served as a additional public prosecutor, got around many convictions and many these things, sir. And Suryapeta district is five top in the Telangana in disposal of the cases in local adalats, sir. Suryapeta district judiciary is supported by the district collector garu, the SP of police, stood fifth in the state in the last national local adalat. The legal fraternity of Suryapeta is doing human services to solve the problems of the people of this district, more particularly in the rural areas. We are conducting many legal awareness camps in the entire Suryapeta district round the clock under the stewardship of our district legal services chairperson and the honorable principal district judge Sri Govardhan Reddy garu and our secretary district legal service authority Srimati Srivani senior civil judge sir, and we are extremely happy. And before I conclude and I quote, నా తెలంగాణ